Aloha, everyone. Welcome back to Out of the Doldrums, your go-to channel for health, lifestyle, and well-being. I'm Dr. Irmina van Dyken, and today we're exploring a fascinating study that reveals how our emotions, particularly negative emotions like anger, can impact our heart health. This information is crucial for understanding how everyday feelings can have serious consequences for our cardiovascular system. Have you ever noticed how your body reacts when you're angry, anxious, or sad? Maybe your heart races, your chest tightens, or you feel a little bit lightheaded. It turns out these feelings do more than just make us uncomfortable. They actually affect the health of our blood vessels. Today, we're focusing on a study published in the Journal of the American Heart Association that looks into this very topic. The study, titled Translational Research on the Acute Effects of Negative Emotions on Vascular Endothelial Health, was conducted by Dr. Daiichi Shimbo and colleagues at Columbia University Medical Center. Supported by the National Institutes of Health, or the NIH, the researchers aimed to understand how negative emotions like anger, anxiety, and sadness affect the cells that line our blood vessels, also called endothelial cells. The researchers involved 280 healthy adults from the age of 18 to 73 with no history of high blood pressure or hypertension, no diabetes, lipid imbalances, or mood disorders. This helped isolate the effects of emotions on vascular health without interference from other variables. Participants were randomly assigned to one of four groups: an anger recall task, an anxiety recall task, a depressed mood recall task, or an emotionally neutral task. This randomization ensures that any differences observed are due to the emotion being studied rather than any other factors. Each group underwent an 8-minute task designed to provoke the specific emotion. For anger and anxiety, participants recalled personal moments that evoked these feelings. For sadness, they used the Velten mood induction technique, which involves reading progressively sadder statements. Examples of these statements include, "I feel so alone," "Nothing seems to go right," and "I'm losing hope." The neutral group performed a simple counting task to control for the effects of speaking and cognitive engagement. So the researchers measured endothelial health indicators before and after the tasks. These included endothelium-dependent vasodilation, or EDV, assessed using the Reactive Hyperemia Index, or RHI, which basically measures how well the blood vessels can dilate in response to increased blood flow. They also measured circulating endothelial cell-derived microparticles, EMPs, and circulating endothelial progenitor cells, EPCs, which are involved in the repair and regeneration of the endothelium. So all in all, they were really just measuring how healthy the endothelium was. Here's what the researchers found. The anger recall task significantly impaired endothelial function, as evidenced by a reduction in the RHI score. This indicates that anger can acutely reduce the ability of blood vessels to dilate properly, which is crucial for maintaining cardiovascular health. The anxiety recall task showed a trend towards impairing endothelial function, but it was not statistically significant. This suggests that while anxiety might have some effect, it's not as pronounced or consistent as the effect of anger. Interestingly, the sadness recall task did not significantly affect endothelial function compared to the neutral condition. This finding suggests that sadness might not have the same acute impact on vascular health as anger or potentially anxiety. So, what does that mean for us? The key takeaway is that anger can acutely impair the health of our blood vessels, potentially increasing our risk for cardiovascular events like strokes and heart attacks. This is particularly concerning for those who experience frequent anger, as it could lead to chronic endothelial dysfunction and contribute to the development of atherosclerosis over time. Now, you might be wondering, what can I do about this? Well, there's many practical strategies to avoid negative emotions and to protect your heart health. Practicing mindfulness and meditation can help you to stay calm, and it can reduce the intensity of negative emotions. Techniques like deep breathing, meditation, and mindfulness can improve your emotional resilience and overall well-being. Adding to that, regular exercise is another great way to relieve stress and improve your mood. physical activity increases the production of endorphins, which are natural mood lifters, and it helps regulate stress hormones. Sometimes even just talking to a friend, a family member, or a therapist can help you process your emotions and feel better. Please don't hesitate to seek professional help if you're struggling with chronic negative emotions. There's cognitive behavioral therapy, or CBT, which is particularly effective for managing anger and anxiety. Healthy lifestyle choices, such as eating a balanced diet, getting enough sleep, avoiding smoking, and limiting alcohol, can all contribute to better emotional and physical health. These habits support your body's ability to cope with stress and maintain overall health. Foods rich in omega-3 fatty acids, like salmon and flax seeds, are particularly beneficial for brain health. Engaging in relaxing activities such as hobbies, relaxation techniques, and spending time in nature can all help reduce stress and improve your mood. Whether it's gardening, painting, or hiking, find what works best for you and make it a regular part of your routine. Learning emotional regulation techniques like progressive muscle relaxation or a practice called non-sleep deep rest, or NSDR, journaling, or using positive affirmations can help manage negative emotions. Reading books like the Relaxation and Stress Reduction Workbook can provide additional techniques and strategies. Remember, your emotional health is just as important as your physical health. By managing our emotions, we can take significant steps towards improving our heart health and our overall well-being. So what do you do to manage stress and negative emotions? Let us know. Share your tips and experiences in the comments below. And if you found this information helpful, please give this video a thumbs up and share it with someone who might benefit from it. Don't forget to subscribe to Out of the Doldrums and hit that bell icon if you want to stay updated on our latest videos. Cherish your health, positive vibes always, and aloha.